ANDI concept of benign breast disease has been explained in this video animation. ANDI is an acronym for aberration in normal development and involution. This concept was first initiated by experts in benign breast disease at Cardiff Breast Unit, led by Professor Ellie Hughes, Robert Mansell, and David Webster. This concept allows us to understand most of the symptoms and presentation of patients suffering from benign breast disease. It is thought that nodularity of the breast, nipple discharge, mastalgia, small lumps in the breast like fibroadenoma, duct papilloma, and breast cysts can all be explained with this pathophysiological concept of ANDI. We shall explain this concept through some anatomical facts. There are 7 to 8 lobes in each breast. These are arranged like bunch of grapes, each grape representing the milk gland or SNS, and the stalk represents the major milk duct opening at the nipple. Each lobe contains 10 to 40 lobules, which in turn are composed of 10 to 100 SNI. These SNI are the basic secretory unit of the breast. The terminal ducts, together with the lobules, constitute terminal ductal lobular unit, known by the acronym TDLU. TDLU is the most hormone responsive and most active part of the mammary gland. The epithelial lining of the ducts and SNI has a luminal and a basal cell layer. The growth of these cells is controlled by the hormones estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen causes development of the ducts and stroma with fat deposition. Progesterone causes maturation and branching of the ductolobular system primed by the estrogen. It also causes secretion within the SNS. Progesterone is also responsible for retention of water within the breast stroma. The blood levels of estrogen and progesterone change with the menstrual cycle. From day 0 of the menstrual cycle, there is a rise in level of estrogen with formation of Graafian follicle in the follicular phase. Lobules are quiescent in this phase. In the post-ovulatory phase, there is a second peak of estrogen along with rising levels of progesterone from corpus luteum. These hormones result in proliferation of cells of the ductolobular epithelium along with increased number of SNI. Moreover, there is increase in the fat and water content within the breast stroma. The net result of these changes is an increase in the breast volume, compelling some ladies to even change their garment to a larger size. The increase in breast volume causes pressure on the pain nerve endings, resulting in breast pain or discomfort. This is called mastalgia. In some degree, this mastalgia is a normal physiological response. However, when it becomes severe and lasts for more than a week, disturbing the activities of daily life, we need to consider it as pathological and treat it. Initially, in most women, there is a uniform growth of cells throughout the breast. Later on, some cells become hyper-responsive to the hormones, resulting in more growth of the ducts and alveoli in some area, resulting in nodularity. If you examine a lady with nodularity in the premenstrual phase, you will encounter pea-sized, often tender nodules scattered throughout the breast with soft and supple breast tissue in between. Marked growth of ductolobular cells along with the stroma in a localized manner may result in formation of a discrete lump in the breast called fibroadenoma. Fibroadenoma is not a true neoplasm and is now considered as part of ANDI manifestation. This view is supported by the fact that some girls experience increased growth of fibroadenoma in the premenstrual phase and reduction in the size after the onset of menstrual flow. Proliferation of the ductal epithelium leads to ductal hyperplasia, which may result in increased secretion presenting as physiological nipple discharge in some ladies. Localized growth of cells within a dilated duct leads to a papilloma formation. It has a central fibrovascular core and papillae lined by myoepithelial and luminal cells. Sometimes the papilloma may undergo infarction by torsion of the stalk, resulting in bloody nipple discharge. In the perimenopausal period, involuntary changes with overgrowth of the fibroconnective tissue around the ducts leads to ductal blockade. Dilatation and unfolding of the lobules along with pent-up secretion result in cyst formation. Initially, microscopic cysts are formed. Many such microscopic cysts may join to form a macrocyst. Thus, we can appreciate that ANDI concept enables us to understand the mechanism of most of the benign breast symptoms, mainly the breast pain, nodularity, the change in breast size, nipple discharge, formation of fibroadenoma, breast cysts, and duct papilloma. Thank you.